الرحيم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته, my dear brothers and sisters and dear viewers of Imam Hussein TV, and welcome to the second segment of this Eid al-Sha'ban special, this Eid beautiful day celebrating the birth of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. I'm your co-host Minhal al-Khafaji alongside my dear brother Mustafa al-Khatib. My dear brother, introduce yourself.
Inshallah. Assalamu alaikum, dear brothers and sisters, respected viewers. Once again, alhamdulillah, that we've got this great opportunity to be at your service and celebrate the birthday anniversary of those great lights, lights of Sha'ban, Imam Hussein alayhi salam. The first birth anniversary is for Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and the second is for Abu Talha Abbas alayhi salam, the moon of the Hashimi tribe. And the third is for Imam Sajjad alayhi salam. And just like this, we've got all those great and beautiful celebrations and birthdays until we receive to the half of Sha'ban, birthday anniversary of Imam Sahib al-Zaman, ajalallah ta'ala farajul sharif. As you know, I'm not alone in this studio, and Brother Minhal, actually, he is the main host, and I'm going to be his co-host, as he just introduces me. So we've got two guests as well. So I would like to introduce Sheikh Mustafa Akhund. Please, Sheikh Ray.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين حبيب إله العالمين بالقاسم المصطفى محمد اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد. Also, I would like to send my condolences to the Imam of our time, Imam al-Mahdi, عجل الله تعالى فرجه الشريف, to Sayyid Khadim, Brother Minhal, Brother Mustafa, and all the viewers of Imam Hussein TV 3 on these auspicious occasions, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with the best Eid, and that is to hasten the appearance of our beloved Imam Imam al-Mahdi, ajalallah ta'ala faraju al-sharif. I'm at your service.
Ahsantum, Sheikh Mustafa. And of course, from the Urdu channel, a representative of the Urdu channel, and the Sayyid, the bloodline of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, running in his blood, Sayyid Kadhum. Assalamu alaikum.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. چونکہ میں یہاں اردو کی طرف سے بیٹھا ہوں اور میں اردو میں گفتگو کرنا چاہوں گا, تو سب سے پہلے تو تمام جہان تشیع اور بالخصوص ہمارے وارث حقیقی امام زمان علیہ السلام کے خدمت میں یہ جو عید کے دن ہیں, اور آج جو ہے تین شعبان حضرت سید شہداء علیہ السلام کی ولادت بسعادت, اور کل کا دن حضرت مولا غازی عباس علیہ السلام. تو لہٰذا تمام جہان تشیع کو اور ہمارے وارث حقیقی امام زمان علیہ السلام کی خدمت میں تہنیت اور تبریک پیش کرتے ہیں.
احسنتم احسنتم سیدنا. Now, Brother Mustafa, if you don't mind, I would like to come to Sheikh Mustafa Akhund and ask him about this beautiful day. Yes, yesterday we discussed the life of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, the virtues, alongside Sayyid Salih al-Qazwini, who couldn't make it today. But today is the eve of the birth of Abul Fadl al-Abbas alayhi salam, Qamar bani Hashim, the moon of the Hashimite clan. What is one of the best ways to learn about Abul Fadl al-Abbas alayhi salam?
Very good question. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, that I'm honored and blessed to be able to discuss with you about life of Abu al-Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, sitting in the dome and the minaret of Abu al-Fadl Abbas is in front of me. Mm-hmm. It's an honor. I'm ever grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also to the Imam Hussein TV channel that has blessed me with this opportunity. Mm-hmm. When we analyze and we read within the history the life of Abu al-Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, we don't see lectures, we don't see ahadith, we don't see sermons. So we have to search to find out exactly where we can find information about Abu al-Fadl Abbas that we can learn from.
Sure. If I'm not mistaken, he's only ever much remembered in Karbala and sometimes in Siffin when he's at the age of 14.
Very true.
It's a very good point that you
very
raise.
True. And when he was in Karbala, he was almost 33, 34 years old. One of the things that we learned just before starting my discussion is about his adab and respect that he has for his master Abu Abdullah al-Hussein, Imam Hassan al-Mujtaba alayhi salam, and the commander of the faithful Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. How we learn this, that we don't see anything from him being uttered, that we can go. So basically he's seeing himself, we can analyze it, we can think of it. When he's in the presence of Imam Ali alayhi salam, after Imam Hassan al-Mujtaba alayhi salam, and then Imam Hussein alayhi salam, he doesn't speak. Because if he would have spoke, we would have had narrators say, okay, he said such and such.
Qal.
No. This is what we understand, that when you are in the presence of the Imam of your time, there is no room for you to talk.
Allah.
Everything is about them. It's not about you. Because when I when I start talking, attentions come to me. Well, there's no more attention going toward the Imam. This is when I was reading and trying to find, it came to my understanding that maybe this is the reason. He doesn't want to get attention to himself.
Okay.
It's all about Imams of Ahl Bayt alayhim as-salam. And this is part of the upbringing of Ummul Banin, salamullah alayha. That when she tells him that, first of all, you never say and call Imam by his name. They are the son of Fatima to Zahra, salamullah alayha. And you are the son of Fatima bint Asad. So all the way, as we know, when we read within the Maqatil, all the way when he falls down from the horse, he called Ya Akh. He calls him by brother. Before that, it's all about Master Sayyidi Mawlai. So this was very important for us. Then when I was reading through his life, I came to Ziyarah of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, which summarizes the personality of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, Abu al-Fadl Abbas alayhi salam. When we, inshallah, I pray for all the viewers to be blessed to visit the shrine of Abu al-Fadl Abbas alayhi salam and Imam Hussein, inshallah, as soon as possible, at least this Ramadan, inshallah.
Ya Allah.
When you stand in front of the shrine, the dhariyah on the right and left, the ziyarah has been written, which has been narrated to us by Imam Sadiq alayhi salam. When we read these segments, Imams of Ahl Bayt alayhi salam, they don't exaggerate. They say exactly what they mean, and they mean what they say.
Point blank.
Exactly. On point. They don't exaggerate, try to sugarcoat it. No.
Never.
Exactly what they have seen and they've heard, they will narrate for us. When we come to the life of Imam Abu al-Fadl Abbas, Imam al-Sadiq says, I bear witness that you had these four characteristics.
Okay.
So one of the best way that we can learn about Abu al-Fadl Abbas alayhi salam is from his ziyarah, from Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam, from a ma'soom.
A ma'soom, an infallible Imam.
We have a lot of the sons of Ahl Bayt alayhim salam. All over Iran, Iraq, Qasim, I don't know, a lot of the sons of Musa ibn Ja'far, alayhi salam. So, but when it comes to Imam Abu al-Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, his ziyarah, very specific, on point, and in detail. Like it takes you a good 5 to 10 minutes for you to read it and analyze it.
Sure.
Imam starts, Ashhadu, I bear witness. Again, keeping in mind, brothers and sisters, Imam al-Sadiq is saying, Ashhadu, I bear witness. Means what I'm about to say is all
true.
He's not going to lie.
Sure.
Yeah, no, 100%.
Ashhadu laka bittaslim. I testify to you of submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Wow.
Taslim.
And this is a great level of a person.
It's a very, very high level for a human being to be at to submit to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the way of Imam Zamana ajallahu ta'ala farajhu sharif. We see taslim in every single minute of Abu al-Fadl Abbas's life. Imam Hassan al-Mujtaba's body has been carried to go and be buried next to his grandfather, Rasulullah. Aisha and the rest of her crew come and they start
shooting arrows at the body
of Imam Hassan al-Mujtaba alayhi salam. Abu al-Fadl Abbas, the brave son of Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, he's there and 70 arrows hit the body of Imam Hassan al-Mujtaba alayhi salam. He's about to take the sword out of the shield. Imam Hussein tells him, the will of my brother was that no blood should be shed.
Wow.
Put it back. Submission. Ashhadu laka bit-taslim.
That must have been so difficult.
Very difficult. I mean, right now, somebody insults us.
Yeah.
We want to give it back.
You've got the power. You're able to just say them all silent. You've got... Mm,
definitely.
You can't do that, but you just...
Be you have to go by the...
Patient because of the order of Imam
submission. I mean, we see this submission within, I mean, the life of Amir al-Mu'minin alayhi salam.
Yeah.
And this has been passed to Abu al-Fadl Abbas alayhi salam. That, as you brother Minhal and Mustafa say, he's able to annihilate them like, done.
Never link up.
Done.
It's gone, all of them gone. But Imam al-Zaman, his Imam al-Zaman says, shield your sword. He shields
wow.
it.
Wow.
Night of Ashura. Umar ibn Sa'd and Shamr and the mother of Abu al-Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, Umm al-Banin, they are from the same tribe.
Okay.
So Shem sends a peace treaty and a peace agreement, sending it to Abu al-Fadl Abbas. Since you are from same tribe as us, we don't want to shed your blood.
Okay.
Come join us.
Wow.
Allah.
How much guts you have to write this kind of letter to Abu al-Fadl Abbas alayhi salam. And Abu al-Fadl Abbas, the rage that is in him.
Yeah.
Again, rage is not a personal rage that I have... I disagree with you personal. No, it's about Imam. It's about Deen.
Yeah.
He's about to go. Imam says, no. Just go tell them, give us one more night. We want to stay all night, pray, supplicate until tomorrow. Tomorrow, every minute he wants to go and just fight. Imam tells him, no. You stay. You are the flag bearer. You're going to stand. While you are there and the flag is up, the women and the children, they feel assured and they feel safe.
Mm.
He keeps want to really go and defend the Imam of his time. Imam says, no, all the way until the end. Even now, you are not allowed to go fight.
Allah.
Go bring me water.
Yeah.
For the tents. Allah.
You as a brave individual, you have the sword. 30,000 people is nothing for you.
And you've passed several battles in Safin and the others. And you've shown your bravery there.
Son of Ali ibn Abi Talib, alayhi salam.
End of the story,
You don't have to say anything else. Even if you are not in... any battle, son of Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam.
That's it.
But within this case, still, you're not allowed to fight.
Wow.
Just go.
Too hard.
Get water and come back. Why? Ashhadu laka bit-taslim.
Full submission.
Complete, absolute submission. This is one thing at least we can learn. I'm going to discuss four characteristics. Taslim. This is what we can learn, brothers and sisters, from the life of Abu al-Fadl Abbas alayhi salam. How much we are submitting ourselves to the will of Imam Zaman Ajallah Ta'ala Farajah Sharif. Well, a brother or a sister might ask, well, the Imam Zaman is not here. How can we submit? How can we submit to Ahl Bayt alayhi salam? I remember one of the brothers, I met him. He used to play an instrument, a musical instrument.
Okay.
And he told me, Sheikh, you are the guy, you guys are the one who said musical instrument is haram. You guys made it haram. Has nothing to do with the religion. I said, okay. He said, when Imam Zamana comes, I'm going to go in front of him. I'm going to take the instrument out. I think it was violin or guitar or something. I'm going to show it to him.
Yeah.
If he says haram, then I will break it in front of him.
Good.
Well, who said Imam Zamana will be in your time?
That's a good question. I told him it's against justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to leave us in this moment in darkness of we don't know what is right and what is wrong.
Mm.
I always emphasize within our shows of us referring back to the ahadith of Ahl Bayt alayhi salam.
Yeah.
To the narrations they have left for us.
Mm.
For example, Avicenna Ibn Sina, as we said in Arabic and Farsi, he has a book about tib, about medicine.
Yeah.
He passed away, I don't know how many decades ago, but until now, we refer to his book. Shakespeare passed away, but within literature, we go and we get his books and plays as of a source of our literature and reading. So even though he passed away, we still use his legacy, what he left for us, to study literature and write poetry and so on and so forth. Einstein within science, physics. So it doesn't mean when a person dies, his legacy, his books, his information 1,000% also dies. Ahl al-Bayt alayhi wasalam, we have good amount of narrations, even though non-Shia and the usurpers of the Khilafah of Ahl-Bayt alayhi salam, they destroyed many of the narrations. But Alhamdulillah, the blessing of Allah and Ahl-Bayt alayhi salam, and our great scholars like Shaykh al-Tusi, Shaykh al-Saduq, Allam al-Halli, Shaykh Allam al-Majlisi, they preserved these narrations. So our submission should be right now to the narrations of the Ahl Bayt alayhi wa
sallam. Okay.
But if I don't know the narrations, how can I submit?
It's impossible.
Action plan. We need to read the narrations of Ahl al-Bayt alayhi wa sallam. On a daily basis, brothers and sisters, one narration a day.
Sure.
How many?
One.
Great. See, Brother Minhal is with
at
us. How many?
At least one. At least one.
One narration a day.
I was with you yesterday with That's the money great. Thing.
I would like to just give you a break, Sheikh, sure. if you don't mind, because we've got lots of questions for you indeed. Sure. Mm-hmm. And Sayyid Husseini, Sayyid Kadhim Husseini, you are not only a guest, you are also a host here in Imam Hussein TV channel, especially in the Urdu language. And lots of respected viewers, they know you. Mm-hmm. And right now, as we've got this show in English, I'm sure that respected viewers who know Urdu, they are familiar with your face. And they are waiting for you to give them some great words and sentences about the birth of Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, please.
But just before he answers, I just wanted to mention that a lot of the time when we are backstage and we are answering the calls of the viewers, especially from the land of Pakistan and India, a lot of them don't speak English, and the only number that they have is the English one. So I think Sayyid Kadhim being here is a great opportunity for those who don't know that there's an Urdu channel, for him to let them know that there's an Urdu channel so they can get in contact with them. Please.
جی انہوں نے فرمایا کہ جہاں تک سوال ہے بہرحال میری ذات کا تو میں ظاہراً امام حسین علیہ السلام فور عالمی چینل میں ایز اے اینکر جو ہے یہاں پہ کام کر رہا ہوں اور میرا ایک پروگرام ہے معرفت منتظر رضی اللہ تعالیٰ فرجہ شریف. تو سوال ان کا یہ ہے کہ حضرت ابو الفضل العباس علیہ السلام کی حیات طیبہ کے بارے میں گفتگو کا سلسلہ, تو اولاً تو دیکھا جائے گا کہ ہمارے پاس جو سلسلہ ہے معصومین کا, تو معصومین علیہ السلام ایک وہ معصومین ہے جو خاص ہیں, جو کہ چاردہ معصوم ہے, اور کچھ معصومین جیسے شخصیت حضرت زینب سلام اللہ علیہا یا حضرت ابو الفضل العباس جو کہ یقیناً یہ بھی معصوم ہے, لیکن بہرحال وہ اختصاصی معصوم جو ان کی شخصیت ہے اس میں ان کا تھوڑا سا فرق ہے, اور فرق یہی ہے کہ ان کو معصوم عامہ کے نام سے یاد کیا جاتا ہے. تو جو حضرت ابو الفضل العباس علیہ السلام کی حیات طیبہ ہے, تو ایک ایسی شخصیت ہمارے پاس موجود ہے کہ اس شخصیت سے یعنی پوری دنیا میں لوگ متاثر ہے, حتیٰ جو شیعہ ہے یا نان شیعہ ہے جو بھی ہے, پوری اس کی شخصیت کچھ ایسی تھی کہ لوگ جو ہے وہ متاثر ہے, اور جو ہی ان کا نام لیا جاتا ہے تو یقیناً ان کے دل میں ایک احترام پیدا ہو جاتا ہے. اور اس میں یہ ہے کہ کچھ ایسے اختصاصات ہیں جو کہ حضرت کے ساتھ خاص ہے وہ چیزیں, اور اس میں سے سب سے پہلی چیز جو ہے وہ امام الوقت کے سامنے وفا کرنا, یعنی خود امام وقت کے سامنے سر بہ تسلیم ہونا, یہ ایک بہت بڑی چیز تھی. اور اس میں جیسے کہ جناب شیخ نے فرمایا کہ حتیٰ کچھ ریلیٹیو بھی تھے کربلا میں, اور ان ریلیٹیو کے وجود بھی حضرت ابو الفضل العباس علیہ السلام امام کے سامنے تسلیم ہوئے, اور انہوں نے وفا کو اور جو حق امامت ہے ان میں وہ بالکل انہوں نے ان سر بہ تسلیم رہے, اور ہر حکم پہ امام کی تعمیل کرتے رہے, اور یہاں تک کہ شہادت کے درجے پر پہنچے. اور اس کے علاوہ دوسری چیز جو تھی, چونکہ یہ بھی انہوں نے فرمایا کہ ایک بہت بڑی جس کو کہا جاتا ہے کہ حضرت امیر المومنین علیہ السلام کے فرزند تھے, تو وہ یقیناً جنگ کرنا چاہتے تھے اور کر سکتے تھے, لیکن اس کے باوجود بھی انہوں نے امام کے حکم پہ صبر اختیار فرمائی, اور وہ صبر کا دامن آخر تک انہوں نے نہیں چھوڑا, اور یہاں تک کہ آخری سخت موقعوں پر جہاں پر پانی کا سلسلہ رہا, اور وہ مکمل طور پہ لشکر جو لشکر تھا وہاں پہ کربلا میں, یہاں جو لشکر تھا انہوں نے بالکل پانی بند کر دیا, اور وہ سخت حالات میں بھی حضرت ابو الفضل العباس علیہ السلام صبر پہ قائم اور دائم رہے, اور اس کے باوجود ایک جو خاص اختصاص ہے وہ خود شجاعت ہے, کہ جو شجاعت بھی امام کی خاص اختصاص میں سے شامل ہے. تو اسی کے ساتھ ہی تھوڑی گفتگو ہے, انشاءاللہ مزید گفتگو کریں.
Thank you so much, Sayyid. That's great. Actually, although maybe I'm not that able to understand or do, but out of your words, you know, once you are just mentioning Abu al-Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, you're talking about the Ahlul Bayt salawatullah wa salam alayhi ajma'in, And this is clear that the hearts all join all together once any person speaks about Ahlul Bayt salawatullahi wa sallam alayhi. I don't know if you also feel the same
The language feels universal.
Yeah, definitely. The type of the language is it doesn't matter. Mm. The important thing is that they are talking about Ahlul Bayt, and the light which comes out of the law, the speaking in the words, it shows the beauty and it shows the power of the virtue of Ahlul Bayt salawatullahi wa sallam alayhi. So now we again with Sheikh, so we can add more about the knowledge of about Abbas sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how we can know him, and is there any way to know him except the narrations and the other things?
I mean, I was really getting into it, then you told him we'll move on. I was like, no, submission, Sheikh, submission.
Yeah. Submission. So we said four characteristics we see within this ziyarah.
Yeah.
So very important, brothers and sisters. So the first action plan was that we read the hadith of Ahl Bayt, one hadith, one narration a day. Before we come ziyarah, it's very important for us. I was in London next to one of a great scholar in London many, many years ago. And it was my first time coming to Karbala after 10 years.
Sheikh, I told him, not that old. Many, many years ago. Well, you make it seem like 70 years ago, Sheikh.
Yeah, kind of. Well, I do look young, but old inside. Old as of knowledge, not old as a person.
Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah.
Inshallah.
The knowledge of, knowledge of
Ahl Bayt, alayhi salam. Should be proud of ourselves that we are. I mean, it's a blessing of Allah, but we should have proud that we are within this madhab and following Ahl Bayt alayhi salam. They have honored us, but alhamdulillah, we also have to be proud of it. He said, before you go to ziyarah, make sure read the ziyarah itself, read the translation, and try to think and understand what you are saying. Because he said, when you get to the ziyarah, when you're inside a shrine, it's completely different atmosphere and emotions and so on and so forth. But before that, when you, before you get there, reading it and understanding it, you will appreciate the words better. So for example, ashhadu laka bit-taslim, submission. We submitting to the words of Ahl Bayt alayhi salam, to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Third action plan will be that let us be truly a submissive individual to Ahl Bayt alayhi salam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning whatever they say halal,
okay. We also say
haram. Okay. Don't get near it. Don't get near it. Be with it. Be with it.
Don't try to find loopholes.
Loopholes, yes. And try to do it some way.
We love doing that stuff. Finding loopholes. Yeah.
And the West, it's not difficult. I lived in West more than 20 years. So I'm telling you many, many years. It's not difficult to live according to the teachings of Muhammad and Ali Muhammad salawatullah alayhi majma'in everywhere.
Yeah.
If we want to, it's not difficult. And that is relative. I mean, it doesn't mean that it's very, very, very easy. No, sometimes you might face difficulties here or there, but general and overall, deen and the religion of Islam is about ease. It's not about usr and difficulties. Ashhadu laka bit-taslim. We said four characteristics Imam al-Sadiq narrates in this ziyarah. Second, wa tasdiq. An honest acceptance as true. Meaning, tasdiq of the Imam of your time. We see during the life of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, people came and they questioned Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Like, why are you going to Karbala? Why are you going toward Kufa? We see his journey toward Kufa and Karbala. Many people came and they told him, okay, why don't you go to Yemen? People of Kufa, their hearts are with you, but their swords are against you. So they tried not reaching this point that whatever Imam says, I trust it and I submit to that because I'm accepting it to be truth. When Rasulullah says about Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, Aliyun ma'al haq wal haqqu ma'a Ali, means accepting Imam completely and never questioning him. Sometimes we can question to understand. We do have a lot of occasions people will come and they ask Imams questions about the existence of God.
And Imam Ali alayhi salam was saying that
Saluni. So questions with the mindset of understanding.
It's okay.
Not questioning the judgment.
Challenging.
Okay. Challenging the Imam. Questioning the authority of the Imam. Wa ashhadu laka bit-taslim wa tasdiq. Third, wal wafa'. Loyalty.
Loyalty.
How much are we loyal to our Imam? Loyalty comes where it will be appear at the time of decision.
Okay.
And every minute of our life when we make decision, we are between evil, shaitan, and Imam al-Zaman. Shaitan to be completely falsehood and batil. And on this side, Imam al-Zaman, ajallahu ta'ala, farajul sharif, haq, truth, beauty, righteousness, spirituality, virtues, everything good. Imam al-Zaman, ajallahu ta'ala, farajul sharif. I open a parenthesis. So, there is no third
direction or path.
Yeah.
Third individual. Either you're with Shaytan or you're with Imam al-Zaman. If you are against the Imam of your time, or not say against the Imam of your time, you don't accept the Imam of your time, or you're still questioning it, or you're not sure. If you're not with Imam al-Zaman,
you're against it.
You fill up the blank.
We don't have any spectrum to stand in.
On the day of Ashura, either you're with Imam Hussein, or you're with Umar ibn Sa'd.
You can't be like the person that said food is good with Muawiyah and
Salah is
good with Ali.
Definitely. In the battle of Safin, in the battle of Jamal, in the battle of Nahrawan, either you are with the commander of the faithful, Amir Mu'minin Ali ibn Abi Talib, or you're with Muawiyah, or you're with Aisha, or you're with Khawarij. It's either or. Haq, batil. Imam Ali alayhi salam, the beauty of their words, one leads to another. Imam says, Shaytan comes. If haq was shown completely, people would have followed it. And if falsehood would have shown completely as a falsehood, people would have avoided. Shaytan comes, takes a mix from here, mix it together.
Yeah.
It seems to be haq, it seems to be truth, but it's but honey
inside,
with the most dangerous poison in it, but it looks honey. Allah.
Nice analogy.
Wal wafa is the words of Imams alayhi salam. We have nothing beauty to say. It's all about the knowledge of Ahl al-Bayt alayhi salam. Nahj al-Balagha, which we need to go back. I'm not going to give Nahj al-Balagha as an action plan. Narration. One narration is sufficient. Wal wafa, loyalty. Who are we loyal to? This dunya.
Allah.
Work. Dunya, world, bills, money, Brother Minhaz.
Yeah, sometimes some people love it a lot, and they also show.
Brother Minhaz's intention is very good.
Actually, everyone.
Money, money. He wants to serve the cause of Ahlul Bayt. Yeah.
I mean, of course. I mean, that's the main plan.
Yes, yeah.
To fund Husseiniyat and orphanages.
Yeah, I'm buying you some time, man. No, definitely. I mean, why do I always say to youth, become a billionaire? We need billionaires.
Yeah.
Have a good luxury life for yourself and spend for the cause of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. Why not? Islam is not against having, I don't know, in London, Range Rovers or Mercedes or whatever cars are good.
If it is halal,
Lamborghini.
Okay.
Have a good luxury life.
Yeah.
Have the big mansion. Mm. No problem. Pay your dues. Mm-hmm. Pay your khums and zakat. Mm. Go to your hajj. Help the needy people. And have a good life. No problem with that. And gain that money from halal, that's the first and foremost important. So, loyalty. So, let me question my own belief, my own personality, my own characteristics. Am I loyal in every decision to the Imam of my time, Imam al-Mahdi, ajallahu ta'ala, farajul sharif, or am I loyal to this world? Why? Because hubbu dunya, as Imam says, ra'su kullu khati'ah, is the head of all evil. Hubbu dunya makes you blind, mute, and deaf. So at the time of decision, history tells us, time of decision, حربنا يزيد الرياحي, loyal, dunya, Umar ibn Sa'd, general of the army, women, money,
everything.
Horses, palaces, or 72, I'm going to be killed within the next hour. Loyalty. Ask the same thing throughout our journey. Inshallah, this year will become the year of the reappearance of our Imam. Inshallah. By our decisions that we have made, when Imam Mahdi reappears, that's the final test. We're being tested, small tests, small quizzes, pop-up quizzes, happens every day. If we pass all of them one after, and that major test, we will be also getting A+ with a 4.0 GPA.
Or A star in the UK.
What is it?
A star,
there you go.
In the UK. Double star.
So, third, wal wafa. Last, wan nasiha. And sincerity.
Yeah.
Righteousness. Nasiha. Always wanting good. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam is bearing witness. This is very big.
Yeah.
that Imam is saying this. So when we read this ziyarah, it's a lengthy ziyarah and needs many nights. Should I continue? Or you guys want to take a break with saying?
No.
Like
go for it.
Go for it.
Go for it.
As long as it's not just because you know, actually, we want to also have words from Brother Sayyid Kadhim. I don't know. We've got also another questions for Sheikh Mustafa.
Yeah.
I'm not going to pause you, but you know, this is your time, and Sheikh Kadhim, actually, we want to have lectures from both of you. And that's why we are sitting right here and just
Sayyid,
learning.
You always have to respect. My of dad course. Said, when it comes to the Sayyid, don't get near Sayyid as far as...
That's it.
For me, I'm just sitting just like a very polite, you know, student and just listening. That's all. Actually.
Well, let us give some time
There are lots of things to say about Abul Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, indeed, no doubt. And Abul Fadl Abbas alayhi salam is a very, very important symbol of respect, or the best symbol of respect towards Ahlul Bayt salawatullahi wa salam alayhi majma'in, as Sheikh Akhund also mentioned. I would like you also to tell the respected viewers who only know or do about the personality of Abul Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, and how respectful Abul Fadl Abbas alayhi salam was towards Imam Hussein alayhi salam, so we can learn, because we are used to learn some action plans and just do them, just have them in our life. And inshallah, you also give action plans to the respected viewers, please.
देखिए एक चीज जो यहां पे نہایت ہی مهم ہے پہلے بھی اس کی طرف ہم اشارہ کر چکے ہیں کہ جو حیثیت حضرت ابو الفضل العباس علیہ السلام کی تھی اور وہ احترام جو وہ حضرت سید الشہداء کے لیے رکھتے تھے اس کے لیے ایک مقدمے کی ضرورت یقینا ہوگی اور وہ یہ ہے کہ ہمارے پاس ظاہر ہے کہ جب اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی کا جو طریقہ رہا وہ یہ رہا کہ جب حجت بھیجتے تھے تو ساتھ میں ایک محافظ بھی بھیج دیتے تھے اور جیسے حضرت موسیٰ علیہ السلام کو اگر دیکھا جائے تو اس کے لیے حضرت ہارون ایک بہترین ناصر رہے اور اس کے بعد اگر دیکھا جائے تو حضرت جناب رسالت مآب صلی اللہ علیہ وآلہ کے بعد جو ہے حضرت امیر المومنین علیہ السلام رہے اور بالکل یہی مقام حضرت امام حسین علیہ السلام کا تھا کہ حضرت غازی عباس علمدار علیہ السلام ان کے ساتھ رہے اور جو ان کی ایک وفا کی ایک داستان ہے تو وہ داستان نہایت ہی عظیم داستان ہے کیونکہ ظاہراً جو یہاں پر حالات کربلا مقدسہ میں جو تواریخ میں ملتا ہے کہ اس دور میں یعنی کل جس کو کہا جائے کہ کل کفر اور کل جو باطل تھے وہ سب کے سب اکٹھا ہو گئے تھے اور ایک طرف جو ہے وہ حق کا میدان ہے تو اس میں حضرت ابو الفضل العباس علیہ السلام کا کردار ان کا صبر ان کا تحمل اور جو دوسری چیزیں تھیں وہ اس سخت حالات میں انہوں نے امام کا ہاتھ نہیں چھوڑا اور حتیٰ کہ حضرت ابو الفضل العباس علیہ السلام کے کچھ اور بھائی بھی تھے جو کہ تاریخ میں لکھتے ہیں کہ ان کو حضرت غازی نے سب سے پہلے بھیج دیا تاکہ یہ شہادت پہ پہنچ جائے اور حالات کچھ ایسے سخت تھے کہ ممکن ہے کہ کسی وقت کوئی گمراہی کا خطرہ نہ رہے تو انہوں نے اپنے بھائیوں کو سب سے پہلے بھیج دیا اور بعد میں آخر میں خود گئے اور خود بھی شہادت تک پہنچے.
Ahsantum Sayyidina, thank you so much. And as we said, like the language of the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam is universal. No matter what country you're from, what language you speak, as soon as you start mentioning the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, you get a glimpse of definitely. What the other person is trying to say. But Sheikh, I want to come back to you. And you mentioned some of the characteristics of Abul Fadl al-Abbas. Are there any other characteristics within this ziyarah that are very important to highlight to the dear viewers?
I think these four characteristics, there are more, what Imam Sadiq mentioned.
Yeah.
Between parentheses, one of my teacher, he said he's in almost 65 year old to 70. Okay. He said his teacher told him, I'm going to tell you 20 lessons that you're going to keep in mind in your life. Get your pen and paper out. We said, we all got the pen and paper out. We start writing. He said, first, such and such and such we wrote, and all of our head is down and we're waiting for him. We're waiting and waiting. He doesn't say anything. We raise our head. Second, third. He said, well, go first. Apply the first one. Then come back. I'll tell you the second one.
I'll tell you the second one.
Because the more you know and you don't apply, the more sin you are getting.
Yeah.
But if you know one And if you didn't apply that one,
that you've only well, done
it's only one.
Exactly.
So these four characteristics, I think if we just focus on the submission part of it, us being submitting ourselves, we read this in Ziyara, وَقَلْبِي مُسَلِّمٌ لَكُمْ After you have submitted yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, absolutely, my heart is submissive to you, وَقَلْبِي مُسَلِّمٌ لَكُمْ وَتَابِعٌ and is following you. So let me examine. When I stand in front of Abu Talib al-Abbas alayhi wasalam, am I truthful? My heart is really, really following Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam.
Is it sincere?
Sincere or not? Very important. Because they know our intention. They read our minds. We see all of these movies with reading the minds.
Yeah.
They are truly Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam when they see you, your forehead, because we have within our hadith that our life journey is written in, on our forehead.
Yeah.
When Ahlul Bayt see us, they see everything about us. So when I stand in front of Abul Fadl Abbas alayhi salam and I say, وَقَلْبِي مُسَلِّمٌ لَكُمْ, my heart is submissive to you and is following you, am I sincere or not? Submissive and submitting, I always say to my audience, let us at least, to be very tangible, let us submit to Ahlul Bayt the same way that we submit to our doctors.
Yeah.
Do we ask them why this medicine is good for me? How did this medicine come to together?
Actually, this is so rude to ask a doctor just like this and challenge him because exactly. He has got the knowledge and you don't have got the. If you had the knowledge, so why did you go to?
Why did you go to the doctor? And if he tells me, like, if I go there and he gives me all of these medical terminologies, I will be lost because this will happen with this and this. Then why did you ask from the beginning?
Exactly.
So submitting ourselves to Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. It should be higher, but I wanted to make it tangible. We don't question our doctor.
Yep.
When we find the right doctor, Allah is our creator. Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, Allah's representative on earth. So Shepherd, we submit.
Sometimes I have seen some people who challenge this. They say, okay, why are you just saying, keep saying that you need to submit to another person? You do taqleed, for example. Also, by taqleed, they say this. Okay, you've got Allah have given you the brain and the mind, and you can just think for yourself and do such and do so, do such. But they don't take care of, they don't pay attention to this thing that, okay, if you don't have the knowledge, this submission is to find the best way. I don't know how to describe it. Maybe my words are not helping that much. But this is because you've got faith to Allah. This is just equivalent to the faith to Allah and Imam. If you've got faith to a person, then you submit to him. But if you don't have faith to him, so you may ask him 1, 2, 3, 4 questions, and you, at the end of the day, you are not satisfied. The reason of submission is the faith. I think that
of
this
course,
is the, no.
The faith is there. It shouldn't be blind following.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
That's
we can see, we see within, I was doing the tafsir of the Holy Quran that I have started in Surah Al-Baqarah and all other chapters. Angels, Allah gave them, He allowed them to ask questions.
Yeah.
When he creates Prophet Adam, he says, are you creating someone that will create, that will bring bloodshed and corruption to this earth? Allah says, I know something that you don't know. So angels are allowed to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, when I say we submit, they have said, don't ask, as you just mentioned. Imam Ali alayhi salam says, Saluni, ask me.
They're encouraging you to ask.
Definitely. We sit on the other side, the non-Shia, it's all about, no, this is it.
Yeah.
It's accepted, just move on with it. Yeah. No, Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, because they have answer for every question.
Sure.
And we have numerous occasions how Imams, they answer the question before the person asking the question. So we're not saying, my personal is about blind. I close my eyes, whatever Imam says, I follow. But doesn't mean that we are not allowed to ask questions. Ask. People came to a lot of time they ask Imams the question. So I have faith in him, but there's also room for me to ask question.
But not to challenge him.
People came and challenged Imams of their time. Imam willingly they accepted, but this is not rude. This is rude. This is not adab. It's not about morality and akhlaq. It's not polite.
Sometimes they do it out of just just for the sake of doing it, not for the sake of actually wanting
to learn
from the Imam.
And Imams know their intention.
Yeah.
Imam knows the intention of them and their father. Indeed. Back and forth completely. And then it continues the ziyara, wa ana lakum tabi'un, and I'm your follower, wa nusrati lakum mu'adda, I am ready to support you.
Mm.
Am I ready to support them? If I have hard time waking up in the morning prayer, and that blanket
is warm, so heavy, it's
heavy, I'm so not cozy,
it's cozy and
comfortable,
warm.
You have
Listen,
to get up.
Here in Iraq, like it gets really hot. But back in the UK, the US, you're from Michigan.
I know.
You're, no, sorry, Virginia.
That's
sorry.
Insulting.
Saying silence from Michigan. You're from Virginia. I'm from London. It's always cold there.
Yes.
And then we're under that blanket and it's so warm and cozy.
That somebody was saying that, Sheikh, that blanket becomes 100 to 250 pounds weight that I'm going to lift, just move it to go and do wudu. But when I come and I say, wa nusrati lakum mu'adda, if I'm not ready, why we've been pushed and encouraged so much to do the ziyarah of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wa salam? Because by saying this, at least we start. Not that I'm not near Ahlul Bayt alayhi wa salam. I have nothing to do with Ahlul Bayt alayhi wa salam. At least I come, verbally I'm saying it.
Yeah.
Slowly, 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 it will get into me. And I will, like when what we do in football and soccer. We get together, we're going to win. We're going to do this. Let's give it a haul and then we go.
You call this soccer, Sheikh. Like, come on. We're from London. It's football, Sheikh.
Well, I'm still American.
Are we going to have this debate on live TV?
No, we'll keep it another 6 minutes with the brothers and sisters.
Inshallah.
So, wa nusrati lakum mu'adda. Let me get myself ready. Physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, religiously. Be ready when Imam Zamana comes. Physically, I cannot walk from here to the haram. Then how am I going to be able to fight alongside Imam Zaman Ajallah Ta'ala Faraj al-Sharif? Religiously, I'm behind my salah, my khums, my zakat, my hijab, my encouraging good, discouraging evil, my haram, my eyes, my hands. All of the body parts, there are some haram that I have committed. Well, I'm going to be ready for you. One of my teachers, he always used to say, with dirty hands, you cannot do a clean job. You have to have a clean hand to do a clean job.
Exactly.
If we want to serve Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, purest of the pure, we have to also purify ourselves also.
So okay, thank you. Thank you so much, Sheikh Naib. That was a great lecture,
yeah,
just like
amazing.
All the other times, all the other nights about Ahlul Bayt salatullah wa salam alayhi. And I would like to mention that no matter how long we sit and talk about Ahlul Bayt salatullah wa salam alayhi, we are not able to count just one virtue of their millions of virtues, but we are trying our best to learn from them.
And I just think it's amazing that 1,400 years on from their lives, we're still sitting here discussing them with so much passion and having, you know, these programs, having these gatherings in Bayn al-Haramain, and just overall having that beautiful atmosphere that we have all year round here in Karbala. I think it's just beautiful.
Alhamdulillah that we are here. We are lovers of Ahlul Bayt salatullah wa salam alayhi ajma'in. Sayyidina Sayyid Kadhim, and we've got only 4 minutes to the end, or three
Inshallah.
Minutes to the end, and we want you also to have a sentence as a final sentence to the respected viewers in Urdu, and inshallah after that we all
Inshallah.
Just finish the show.
Ji badi achhi guftugu mashallah hui, aur jis tarike se جناب شیخ نے اس نکات کی طرف اشارہ فرمایا تو بڑی ضرورت ہے آج کل کے دور میں جو خصوصی امام زمانہ علیہ السلام کے عنوان سے جو ہماری ذمہ داریاں ہیں وہ ہمیں بہرحال نبھانی ہے اور اس پر کوشش کرنی ہے لیکن ایک نکتہ جو میں آخر میں کہنا چاہتا ہوں کربلا مقدسہ کے عنوان سے وہ یہ ہے کہ ٹھیک ہے مثلا دور ایسا ہے کہ کرونا کا مسئلہ ہے اور اتنی آسانی سے کربلا تو کوئی آ نہیں سکتا لیکن کوشش یہ کرنی چاہیے کہ حد عقل انسان کی کوشش ہو اور نیت یہ ہونی چاہیے کہ کربلا مقدسہ ہم نے ایک نہ ایک دن آنا ہے اور اس کے لیے اگر انسان اور کچھ بھی نہ کر سکے تو گھر بیٹھے زیارت پڑھ سکتے ہیں اور اس کے علاوہ اس قسم کے پروگرامز اور یہ چیزیں دیکھ کے بھی آپ فیض حاصل کر سکتے ہیں تو ان چیزوں کی طرف مخصوصاً آپ نے توجہ کرنی ہے اور اسی سے ہی دل نازنین امام زمانہ علیہ السلام کو خوش بھی کرنا ہے
انشاءاللہ
احسنتم سیدنا thank you so much شیخنہ any final words from you to the dear viewers
action plan will remind of them I love these action plan because it reminds me first and foremost before the viewers, let us hold on to the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. They are the path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Physically right now we, due to our sins and due to what has happened, we cannot see the Imam. If we want to and if we work an Imam once we can, and we have a lot of stories of people seeing the Imam, but at least what we have from them is their narrations, which will illuminate our path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna al-Husayn misbahul huda wa safinatun najat. Let us hold on to them as tight as we can, and inshallah it will get us to our
salvation. Something beautiful just to mention here quickly before we end. I remember hearing this story. One of the sayyids was on a minbar and he was talking about one of the maraji' who was talking about how he passed out in the desert and then he saw the Imam, and you know, he was asking Mata Arak, and he was asking Mata Tasha. When he said to him, when can I see you?
Whenever,
and he said to him,
want.
When do you want to see me?
Yes.
Because we're not ready for it. Brother Mustafa, any final words?
Actually, for the final words only, I can, as Sayyid Ghala mentioned, first and foremost, we say, Allahumma ajjil li waliyik al-faraj, may Allah hasten the reappearance of Imam of our time. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it possible for all respected viewers to be here in Karbala soon.
Ahsantum, Brother Mustafa. I want to thank everyone who's been on here, Sayyid, the Sheikh, and Brother Mustafa here. But from me and everyone here, from Imam Hussein TV, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.
Ahsantum. Thank you.
Ahsantum.
Shabbat.